let me first of all thank the European Parliament for the opportunity to exchange views on this very important topic and subject. We all closely follow the developments in Turkey, a candidate country and a key partner for the European Union. Our commitment to further developing and broadening our ongoing partnership and cooperation with Turkey remains strong. This is demonstrated by our continued solid engagement, including the recent visit to Turkey by High Representative Federica Mogherini and Commissioners Hahn, Avramopoulos, Stylianides and Shevchovich to Turkey and numerous meetings with Turkish authorities. The recent period has been a testing time for Turkey. The attempted COP of 15 of July risked sending the country back in time to a darker era of its history. It would have been a dramatic blow to Turkey's democracy and destabilized the whole region even further. On that night, the people and the institutions of Turkey, including all political partners and parties, came together and stood up to defend their democracy. This is something we cannot forget nor downplay. In this delicate moment for the country's history, the Turkish institutions must recommit strongly to the same values that the Turkish people defended on the night of 15 July. Although the state is naturally entitled to take swift and decisive action in response to such a threat, any allegation of wrongdoing should be established via transparent procedures in all individual cases and ensure the right to respect for private and family life. Freedom of expression is one of the essential foundations of the European Union. We have repeatedly stressed that Turkey, as a candidate country, needs to aspire to the highest possible democratic standards and practices, including freedom of the media. This is our second debate on the situation of journalists in Turkey under this legislature. And when we look at the situation of journalists and media freedom more generally, it has been deteriorating significantly, not just since 15 of July, but over the last couple of years. It is very worrying that following the introduction of the state of emergency, the situation of media freedom in Turkey has been exacerbated even further. Arrest warrants have been issued against a large number of journalists and many media outlets have been closed. There have been cases of foreign journalists facing difficulties in exercising their profession in Turkey, such as deportation, refusal of entry, and refusal to renew their press accreditation. Turkish authorities need to restore safeguards to ensure freedom of expression, including pluralism of the media, and to take measures to limit intimidation and pressure exerted on journalists and media outlets. Turkey is encouraged to make measures, including the adoption of guidelines and training for the judiciary to curtail the use of defamation and related criminal code articles as a means of putting pressure on critics. We urge the Turkish authorities to refrain from blocking access to internet content and from takedowns. All these issues of concern are central for the European Union, and we very much encourage cooperation with the Council of Europe in this regard. Free, diverse and independent media is essential in any democratic society. Without freedom of expression and freedom of the media, an informed, active and engaged citizenry is impossible. It is the strength of a democratic society to be able to respond to anti-democratic acts by strictly adhering to these standards, and this is absolutely critical for our relations. The curtailment of freedom of speech in Turkey is not limited only to the journalists. On the 20th of May, the Turkish parliament adopted a constitutional amendment on lifting the parliamentary immunity of a number of members of parliament. Prosecutors began to summon members of parliament to testify, and this raises further concerns about the respect for the rule of law and fundamental freedoms, in particular the freedom of expression. It is precisely the same issue that needs to be addressed under one of the seven outstanding benchmarks in the framework of the visa liberalisation dialogue related to the anti-terror legislation. Let us be very clear, this benchmark is not about asking Turkey to reduce its capacity to fight terrorism. This benchmark is about making sure that the anti-terror legislation and its application are aligned with the case law of the European Court of Human Rights. In short, that it cannot be used to jail journalists who only did their job and to curtail freedom of expression. The European Union believes that it is important to continue to address these important matters as a key element of a dialogue between the European Union and Turkey, a candidate country, but also a key partner to the European Union. Thank you very much, and I am looking forward to our debate.